right, now onto surface dysgraphia.
Yeah, and that's the opposite of phonological dysgraphia. So in phonological dysgraphia, you're not too bad at spelling words as holes, but you don't know the sound spelling rules. The opposite is you know the sound spelling rules, but you can't spell words as holes. And in some languages, that won't matter, because in languages like Italian and Hungarian and Polish, every word can be spelt according to rules. So you have none of these awful words like have or said, which ask you to spell them as H-A-V or S-E-D. Those don't exist in many European languages, but in English they do. And in English, there are many more words that are irregular for spelling than are irregular for reading. So if you take the word, let's think of an example, paid, P-A-I-D. That's regular for reading because the A-I is pronounced A, so you won't have any problem. But if I say spell paid and you don't have the stored information there, how will you know whether to write P-A-I-D or P-A-D-E? They're both okay. One of them's wrong. And if you're a surface dysgraphic and you haven't got the store saying it's P-A-I-D, so you have to use the rules, you won't know whether to write P-A-I-D or P-A-D-E. And if you think about the words of English, how many have two possible or two or more possible spellings? Many, many of them. And so it's a real problem for spelling English if you don't have the stored correct spelling and you have to use the sound to letter rules, you'll misspell many words.
Definitely.